Jackson. Behind him then, the guy who's been flying all season, out here with an absolute... Behind him then, the guy who just looks so lonely, if there's a couple of folk on the car, compared to 37. Eddie certainly looks to be just as quick as him there. 544 PE. Asco there, courtesy of 88. Pete McVeigh and 29 Stuart McCammon goes round as well. To see if he can get the car fired up and onto the raceway, certainly still aligned. Up front then, Ray Coy in the lead, but just look at his big bag behind him. Something surely got to give. Alan Stirling happy to them all. Nearly going the same way, number 8. Peter Huntley gets spun around into the lane behind the home straight. And a magnificent roll over there by 168, Steve McLaren brings out the hill. Leader always 221, Ray Coy. Ray Robinson into the wall hard over there at the big corner. Looks like all the carnage, all the cars on the move and clearing themselves out to that 162. Getting out to Pam's way in the next. Seven this time it is to rise up into head the affairs. It is number 88, Pete McVeigh. One or two more and right the wall here. And the race against the wall here in 777. Oliver Parks is managing to avoid him, the European champion. Goes hard in the first and second in fact in the European Championship. Hard in that one. Together as 2-0-6 continues to lead. Andy Horn finds a nice gap there. And it looks like two cars touching out there. So 3-0-5 and Jim Jamieson senior. So then the Formula 2 Challenge Trophy, 3-0-9 Brian Forrest and the Scottish champion Brent Tootle. He has quite an advantage as the yellow comes out in 2-65. Brent now is into the closing stages and don't rule out Ian Thompson either. That car has been looking leading away. 176, Gary Coffey in second spot. He tries to hang on to in third place, Alan Stirling. Fulton gets spun around dramatically here on the entrance to the home straight and goes round. Weekend for him, certainly money-wise, is £100. Looking well to be going away. Experience of the 353 car of Robin Yule paid before the end of this one. And car onto his roof then, 280. David Syme landed on his roof there, so that brings out the yellows of the cars. Slow down very, very quickly. .241 then, Alan Nicholson's got himself a little advantage now over 2 and 79 trying to follow suit, but 309 Brian Forrest. 309 Brian Forrest. And Forrest now right on the back bumper of the 600 car and he moves through into the lead. A pile up develops an entrance to the back straight and the yellows come out quickly into third spot. Beyond that, 62, 199 just by as well. Action already started out there in the track. 88, Pete McVeigh becoming a crunch over there on the turnstile bend. 88 goes, he's abandoned out on the track. His car looking going to retire in 1-1-80. Indeed does park the car up behind the goals. 369, car there bouncing off the wall. That's Andy Sands. 68, Stevie Clark into third place. 680 gets spun around here on home straight, courtesy of 117 and the number 8, Peter Hunter. And Heapsayer getting tapped as Willie McGrouther becomes another one to pat the car up. He's parked up behind the goals as well. 146 spins off and that's a bit of oil down there, oil line down. at the corner and the yellow flag's out then. And all the cars then go piling into the wall. Wheels come flying off as well as one or two cars get. 282, James Harris. 265, Barry Stephen. Hard in to the back of 282. And I don't know if the throttle maybe even stuck. For 3250, Davey Orr then. 480, 665, Richie Brunson has a problem. Around there and comes to halt in the entrance to the Sean Webster in the 402 car, spinning around number 8 off Peter Hunter. And the race leader then has problems, he's on his roof, 120 car, David McCullough is on his roof. Dips down the inside, he's going to lead as the cars come round to complete their first lap. That's Goodson. 250 Davey Orr third after 904 Paul Winfield. 600 Brent Tuttle quickly on the move as well. 309 gets Stu Gilchrist. Dermot McGoyne looking to be exceptionally quick out.